Central side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Mississippi State, a team and a program that year in, year out, has got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two, and they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact that you throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 23. Now he tries to buy some time. And he's sacked.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
And they'll probably try to throw here. They line up on third down and 14. He goes out of bounds, right around the 30.
It was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And he hauls it in. He's tackled right around midfield.
Good job here by the receiver. Look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
From midfield, first down. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
Gets to about the 27-yard line.
That's good for gaining 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 27.
Here I come again. Here I come again. Here I come again.
He has some room. Makes it to the 17. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
The 10, the 5, and that sets them up with a first and goal. First and goal from the 1. Expect to see something straight up the middle. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. Touchdown, LSU! And he converts the extra point. It was a 6-play, 64-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
LSU is ready to kick it away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. LSU's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync to this team.
He's taken down around the 43-yard line. And down he goes around the 45-yard line. He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From the 40-yard line, second down. Looks middle, got his back, and he's taken down right around the 42-yard line. That's a 2-yard loss.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call. For not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
From their own 33-yard line, first down, LSU is up a score. Throws a strike over the middle. Tackle made around the 48-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he shoved out of bounds at the 26. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line. And he he's tackled at the 26-yard line.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
To fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted.
That was perfect coverage against a pretty good route. He was all over that pass.
These are plays you don't expect a freshman to make, but this kid has the potential to be something really special. From their own 17-yard line, it's first down. And hit hard as he came down with it. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Looks like we're going to have a good game on our hands after one. 7-0, Tigers. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. He tackles him for a loss.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
Now it's 3rd and 9 coming up. Ball on the 17. They'll bring him down around the 25-yard line.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
He makes it to the 45-yard line. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Zips it to the tight end, and he tackles him hard at the 44. From the 44-yard line, first down. LSU is up 7. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Caught, enough for the first down. Complete, brought down around the 28-yard line. From the 28-yard line, first down. Gets it. He's in space. Touchdown. Big play. Wow. An almost impossible pass to defend, and it goes for 6.
Yep. The defense would have needed 12 guys on the field that time.
Hits the PAT. A 4-play, 55-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Hit immediately. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. he's hit immediately in the backfield. The lineman had a big push there to get in the backfield and bring him down.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
He's tackled at the 44-yard line. Quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. He makes it to the 45-yard line. From their own 45-yard line, second down. Level at the 32.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
From the 32-yard line, it's first down. Tackle at the 29-yard line. Stop at the 25. The halfback just couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Loss of one. Gets it up, and it's long enough, and he nails the long field goal.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
17 to nothing, LSU. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Bulldogs know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Slings it. He's tackled at the 46.
I like it. They're not afraid to try this defense over the middle. The quarterback saw man coverage and gave his receiver a chance to make a play. They picked up the first down. I wouldn't be surprised to see them come back to that play.
Quick throw. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Mississippi State will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. Hit before he can go anywhere.
That makes it first and 10.
Ready! Green 19!
Scrambling around. Dives for extra yardage. Strike to his receiver, no good.
down, and they need to get it down to the 20. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Good tackle there in space. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. He's going to try and scramble, and they get the sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
So with the half ending, they're just going to try to put 3 points up on the board. Kicks away, and he got it. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Tigers lead it by 2 touchdowns.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This first half is the one that's kept us busier in the studio than any other. Every other game around the country wanting constant updates from this potential upset that's brewing right now, sort of capture the fancy across the fruited plain.
Oh man, my phone's blowing up. Everybody's like, what's going on? How is this possible? We never saw it coming, but it's happening. And it's one of those weeks in college football where we always talk about, you better come ready to play every single week. And if you don't, this can happen. Guess what, Reese? Kids don't believe that. It's not going to happen to us.
Sure, Coach. It couldn't happen to me.
No, we're looking ahead. We got those big dogs coming down the road. It's right in your face. You got the next 30 minutes to fix it. But right now, it's definitely not looking good.
I can only hope that Nestler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese Davis, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So we're just about ready to return to action. Makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Second and nine. Ball on the 26. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
To the tailback, and down he goes around the 30-yard line. He's to the 40. He makes it to the 42-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
He faked out everybody in the stadium. When you can sell the run that well, you're going to have the upper hand on the defense.
They come out in an empty backfield. He's on the run. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
Nice gain as he works to the right side. After decent pickup.
second and six.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. That's a great tackle at the 10. Mississippi State. Well, the quarterback just showed us he can beat you with his feet as well as his arm.
And what a dangerous weapon this guy is.
And he tacks on the extra point. To kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Mississippi State's a team that nobody gave a chance today, but they're right where they want to be.
I think just the mindset of this football team, they need to be complimented for that, because it's easy to come in, be a bit intimidated, be a bit overwhelmed. They've put that to the side, gone out and executed, and I think the longer they've stayed in this game, the more confidence that's instilled.
Tackle made around the 35-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. LSU is up a score. Here he goes. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Again, makes it out to about the 50.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He's on the run. He's at the 40. He's at the 30, to the 20, and he's tackled at about the 11. See now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. Steps up in the pocket. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. Play ever developed nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
One of the things a quarterback's looking for before the ball is snapped on a post route is to see if he has one safety in the middle of the field. Because with one safety, you can use your eyes to move that safety and then throw back the other way for the touchdown. I thought the quarterback that time did a really good job of managing that safety and eventually making the throw for the touchdown.
He sends this one deep. Brought down at the 18. Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
from their own 16-yard line. Second down. Is out for the tailback on the screen. He steps out at the 25-yard line.
That makes it 3rd and 3.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup. He's scrambling. And he stays in bounds to make the catch. Draw play. Taken down in the backfield. Second and 12. Ball on the 39-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five-wide outlook. He's pushed out of bounds at the 34. Five wide. Bring him down at the 20.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. That makes it 1st and 10.
Ready!
Brought down at about the 13. And that'll bring this third quarter to a close. 24-10, Tigers. In this very pivotal fourth quarter. Touchdown, Bulldogs. The extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. LSU is up by a touchdown. And he hits him hard at the 40-yard line. From their own 40-yard line, 1st down. To his receiver. Tackle right around the 48-yard line. Quick throw incomplete. Wanted his receiver. From the 48-yard line, it's 2nd down. There's a strike complete, and they make the stop at the 48. Right,
rifles it. And he's immediately tackled.
Well, you give up too many passes like that, and the game will be done before you know it. They cannot let these receivers get behind them.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Gets out to around the six. LSU is up seven. Finds the tight end for a touchdown. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Well, I'm sure Reese is having fun giving updates from this game to our other games going on today. We've had back-to-back-to-back-to-back scores.
They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time. He's tackled at about the 49.
Here we go.
He throws. Completes. It's the junior. He's taken down around the 12-yard line. Man, oh, what a hit.
That brings him second and five.
Fires a laser touchdown. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Well, somewhere Andre Ware's doing a game today, and he'd be smiling if he was doing this one. We've got nothing but offense going on in this football game.
The offense is coming out on the field, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone lately.
Well, I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
From their own 23-yard line, second down, just under three to go in regulation. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's to the 40. Across midfield. And down he goes. Right around the 30.
That's a tough catch for the receiver on a ball coming in from that angle. But he did a really nice job of looking it into his hands and concentrating all the way.
And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
From the 30-yard line, second down. Here's the
Here's the halfback on the screen. He gets hit out of bounds at the 14. From the 14-yard line, first down. And they get nice yardage on that run. Mississippi State will take their second time out of the half. Just under two to go in the game. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Defense has got to do a better job of being more aggressive. You know, this offense doesn't seem to be in much of a hurry. They're working the clock. You know the chances are they're going to run the football. That allows the defense to pin their ears back.
Touchdown, Tigers! The play clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Delayed game. Offense.
And he converts the extra point. LSU to kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Knocked out of bounds at the 26-yard line.
The Bulldogs have put up 24 unanswered points. One team can't do anything wrong. The other team can't do anything right.
Not sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
It was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
He lets it fly, and he hauls it in at the end of that long ball. And he's taken down around the 30-yard line. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Slings it. There's a very impressive open field tackle. He's got 100 yards in the game now.
Yo, this guy continues to make plays, and what this can do is force the defense to have to double team. And if a defense starts to double team a wide receiver, it opens up avenues for other wide receivers and also the running game to try to exploit the defense.
Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. And he's leveled at the 11-yard line. Caught out in the open. Touchdown, Mississippi State. And that touchdown gets these guys right back in the game. We're looking at a one-score ball game now. And he hits the PAT. So a six-play, 74-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
The score now, 38-31. The thing you got going for you defensively, you know your offense is doing their job. You just have to do yours.
Yeah, I think one time you have to be able to go out there on the field together and look around and say, guys, I know we're not playing well, but just one stop. The way our offense is playing, if we can come up with one stop, we can win this game.
This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defense has changed things up as they try to stop these guys.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Under a minute left in the game. They bring him down in the backfield. And this one's all but wrapped up. The Tigers with the victory, 38-31. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.